All right, so we finally got the Miesha Tate Ronda Rousey 2 fight. This rematch has been highly anticipated, at least by me. I know a lot of people wanted to see it as well. It's one of those fights where it actually has a story to it. It's not just, another fight on another show. It's a fight with significant meaning. Plus, you have the backstory with how this fight came about, and it's not really a traditional way. I mean, one girl got hurt, the other girl got moved up to the ranking, which I thought was bullshit from the get-go, just because Miesha Tate lost her last fight decisively, and how she stayed at number two, I don't know, but she did in the rankings, that is. But that's another story. The point is, tonight's fight, Miesha came out with some good game. I was very, very, very surprised. She got plenty of good licks on Ronda, especially in the first round. I thought some of the jabs that she connected with quite well. You started to see Ronda didn't get too dazed, but you can see it definitely took a toll on her. You can tell from when she was trying to get the takedowns, her aggressiveness diminished a little bit as the first round progressed. In the second round, I think Ronda just. I mean, as if she didn't do this enough in the first round. And by the way, I had Ronda winning all 3 rounds prior to the submission. She was just taking down Tate like every chance she got. And if she didn't get the chance, she made that chance come to her. And that was one thing that surprised me about Tate, was that when, it seemed like the striking game was working in her favor very well, she tried to continuously go for takedowns or at least charge her towards the midsection area. And I'm just like, why are you doing that? Clearly, that's not your game. That's her game. And she's demonstrating it to you time after time. And in this fight as well, I was very confused by that. Of course, as you know, Ronda wins by submission with the arm bar in the third round. And now here comes again, every time Ronda wins a fight, because all the fights she's won have been via arm bar, here we go again. She a one-trick pony. The way I see it is, if she's a one-trick pony, then someone should be able to stop her, because one-trick ponies are easily read. You can read what they're doing, So this one-trick pony BS is nonsense to me. The post-fight, the aftermath of the fight, I completely understand, and I get why, and I'm okay with Ronda not shaking her hand. Those of you who booed, those of you who might have, I don't know, that just hated that, or you went on Twitter, wherever it is, Facebook, I don't know, whatever it is, forums, wherever it is that you're expressing your distaste for Ronda not shaking Tate's hand. Did you guys not watch Ultimate Fighter? Do you guys not know what Tate's been saying about Rousey and her family? Like, it's nonsense to me. For those of you who are saying, well, she's just a bitch, she doesn't want to shake her hand, you either A, don't watch MMA, B, don't watch Ultimate Fighter at least, or C, you don't know anything about this feud in general, or D, all of the above, because there's no reason why someone out there should say she should have shook in her hand. After the fight, Ronda, gave Miesha credit. She said she was a great fighter. She put up a great fight, which she did. She looked very good in this fight, which is, I didn't think she was going to put up that good of a fight, and she came out there and she did very well, actually. So kudos to Miesha Tate for that. But I don't. I if I'm Ronda, I wouldn't shake someone's hand who has disrespected my family repeatedly over the past few months, who talked so much and got away with so much shit on the Ultimate Fighter without being punished, while Ronda wasn't able to retaliate back. So this was her retaliation. Armbar victory again. Good for Ronda. And now she's gonna face Kat Zingano, who before this fight, I believe actually it was actually yesterday on Friday, when Dana White already said, Kat Zingano's got the winner between this fight, the winner of this fight, because she was the one who was supposed to fight Ronda in the first week, because she's already beaten Miesha Tate. And excuse my phone there. But yeah, Kat Zingano and Ronda Rousey, I don't know, maybe they'll say that for the July 4th weekend show. Who knows? But yeah.